solution of E in terms of the Eban coordinates, but note that it only gives the, that's unlike the relativistic case where the matter was solved in terms of all Eban coordinates. Here, the E is only solved in terms of the time coordinates. But that's okay, because these were all nonlinearities. We all had nonlinearity in the time coordinates, not in the time, in the spatial coordinates. So there was no need for E. E shouldn't become the spatial. So that exactly is what we want. So tomorrow I will say a few more things about this, but basically we have now the answer, because the omega to the zero is just calculating. Let me give you the final answer, and then I make some remarks tomorrow, then I finish it. So the order of action for the particle, and that's then the end, is equal to minus 1/2 integral in tau times minus 1 over E times E mu A x dot mu E mu B x dot mu delta A B plus 2 over E tau mu x dot mu and mu x dot mu plus 1 over E lambda times tau mu x dot mu minus m e. And to really finish it, it turns out that this m term and this delta is exactly again the boost invariant h mu. Okay, so this term just combines with that, and then you get that that's the final answer. And I will start that tomorrow then. Is minus 1/2 integral tau of minus 1 over E times h dot mu h mu mu, the boost invariant metric in the spatial directions, plus one single Lagrangian multiplier term, E1 of E lambda times tau mu h dot mu minus n. I'll show you tomorrow how this brings you exactly back to the number go to action if you solve for the lambda and E, and then I will discuss what happens in the case of strings and how we can use this information to derive the analog of the Boucher rules, so the non-trivial T-leptons, and there we'll see some surprises that some things which are kind of fun, not expected. It's exactly 4:00, so I think I stop on that. Okay.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
This thing that you presented as a trick to get rid of this divergence.
Yeah.
Is it just that when you have the E in there as the extra field, that you need to define what you mean by a non-relativistic, consistent non-relativistic limit?
Yeah, it's a way of defining the limit. So it's really the trick also occurs in a very simple way. If you take a massive particle and you want to take that usually is m times the kinetic term, you ask yourself, what's the mass's limit? Then I say m to zero, but then everything disappears. You should not do that. So there also is a similar trick. You introduce then the Einbein and you write the mass term as a separate mass term. And then you take the limit, the mass term goes to zero, and you get the mass's particle with p squared is zero. It's a bit in that spirit that I do it. So there also, it's a bit cheating because in the case of the massive particle, you can't go back in the massive case. It's a way to define the limit. It's legitimate. But it's very similar to that trick. You talk about the set of charge case fields.
And the fact that you have these nonlinear transformations.
Yeah, one interpretation is that set of charges usually have a translation in one dimension higher, and that is due to the fact that the Barkin algebra can be embedded in a Fanon-Gray algebra of one dimension higher. And what it means is that if you take generativity in five dimensions and you do a null reduction, then you get Newton-Newton derivative. So it's a trick. It's an easy trick if you want to get a normative out of a relativistic one. You do a null reduction, you always get something normativistic, because the isometry is preserving the null character of the killing vector is exactly the Barkin search. But it's a really a dirty trick and nothing more. You should not confuse it with a Kunze Klein reduction, where you have Kunze Klein modes, massive modes, and then you really can uncover an extra dimension. Because it's a non-compact thing. So it's not something like Kunze Klein modes or so. It's really a dirty trick to get out of a relativistic answer, a non-relativistic answer. But in that sense, indeed, there is a kind of high dimensional interpretation. Only, I should say, also on shell, you cannot do this. The danger of this trick, that's why you cannot do it at the level direction, is that if you take geometry, the remaining geometry, and you assume a null killing vector, which you need, otherwise, a common reduction, that's a constraint on your geometry that needs a certain scalar in zero, because the k squared is a scalar. So, some comes a quite scalar, you have to set it to zero, which means that you don't do the most general reduction. Which means that if you would do it in the action, you lose an equation of motion. It simply would be wrong. You can only do it at the level of the equations of motion. It's a bit dangerous because you have a constraint in the joint. It's not the most, you don't make the most general answers for your metric. Because you leave out one term, because otherwise you don't have a null killing vector. And that means you have to be careful of not losing the equations of motion. So you have to get it only at the level of the equations of motion. Bit. Sorry that my answer is so long, but also it reminds me to say that there is no action for these new Newton fields. I've never seen in the literature the analog of an Einstein new action. So there are equations of motions that they are there, and they can be obtained as a limit of the Einstein equations of motions. But if you take the same limit in the Einstein new action, things blow up. There is no simple action. I'm not saying there is no action, because if I say this, people say, if this, that, why is no action? Maybe there is an action, but I've never seen it in the literature so far.
Okay,
could
you tell me in the non-relativity limit, why there is the first term is not minus sign 1 over e?
Sorry, I made somewhere a mistake. Say it again. There is a sign wrong?
Yeah. Why there is not minus
this,
sign?
This minus?
Yes.
It's not minus. Let me see. Why did I say, let me see. You say it's not minus. I have to, they see also minus here, right? For sure.
In the...
You say this is not a minus?
No. The up down.
Here.
Up down.
Sorry, there.
Down.
Here.
Yes.
Sorry. I see. You're quite right, because this is a theta 0, 0, so it's minus 1, sure. Sorry, here's the theta 0, 0. I'll check it. Let me give the answer tomorrow. You're not maybe right, but I don't want to change the kick. I'll check it.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so let's just thank you, right? Thank you.